Does your computer run like your grandma's old laptop that she only uses to post pictures on Facebook? If you said yes, then you're in the right place, my friend. Today, I'm gonna show you, yes, you, how to optimize your Windows 11 for better overall performance. Before we get started, a quick thank you to EasyUS for sponsoring this video. Now, there's a lot of videos out there showing you these little settings that may tweak a little few things, but they don't really do very much for the system overall. I'm gonna be showing you the settings that really matter when you want the absolute most out of your computer. The first one may be a little contradictory, but it doesn't make it any less important to getting the absolute most out of your computer. If you go to your settings, you'll see on the left-hand side that there's a panel called Windows Update. But don't skip this part, because there's an extra setting in there that you may not know about. When you click here, there may be updates ready to be installed, but for me, there aren't any at the moment. Don't forget to check the advanced options here for optional updates. These may be very important in getting your computer to run smoothly. And yes, I know, nobody likes Windows updates, but hey, sometimes they're actually useful. And Windows updates can't do everything for you, so you're gonna have to find some of these updates yourself. Depending on the specs for your system, you're gonna need to find the drivers for your processor, whether that be AMD or Intel. You'll also want to download graphics drivers for AMD, Nvidia, or Intel, I guess, if you're one of the very few people that actually bought one of those. If you're using a laptop, the GPU drivers are usually part of the CPU installation. You can find every driver that you need listed on the company's websites. Have you been in a situation where you just bought a new game, but then you see that your drive is full, and then it sends you into a panic about what you have to delete to make room? Clearing out old or unused applications can definitely help speed up your drive. I recommend going to the Apps section in the settings, since all downloaded apps plus the ones from the Microsoft Store, if you actually download things from there, will appear here. If you use a laptop where you use one drive for everything, and no, not that kind of one drive, I recommend using EasyUS Partition Manager. This will help you create partitions for games, documents, whatever else you may need to make room for. This is an all-in-one partition manager that works perfectly with Windows 7 up to Windows 11. It makes it super simple to partition or even clone your drives to another machine. In the EasyUS Partition Master and the Partition Manager section, we're gonna select our C drive, and we're gonna right-click and select Move or Resize. As you can see, it's super simple to resize these, as you can just drag out the size that you need, and we're gonna hit OK on here. And it shouldn't take too long, and as you can see, it is already done. Here in the clone section, you see that we have Migrate OS, Clone OS Disk, Clone Data Disk, and Clone a Partition. And these are super, super useful for people that really like redundant data storage. In Partition Recovery, you can choose a disk and start searching for lost partitions. So we're gonna select our disk here, do a new scan, and this shouldn't take too long either. And as you can see, that is already done with the quick scan here, and it looks like it did not find any missing partitions, so we are all set here. Last one I wanted to talk about here is the toolkit, which gives you ISOs for Windows 7, 8, 10, 11. You can create a bootable USB drive to reset a computer's Windows password, have boot repair, write protection, you can rebuild your computer's MBR tables, and you have 4K alignment here. As you can see, EasyUS Partition Master is very, very useful software, so make sure that you go down to the link and download for free. Sometimes, booting up your computer feels like it takes an eternity. After all, you just want to watch YouTube or play video games or something, right? This is usually due to Windows starting applications just as you're logging in. To disable these, you're going to want to head to the Task Manager. Here, there will be a tab at the top called Startup, and here you can choose whether you'd like an application to start as you log in, or if you'd prefer to keep that app from starting up at all. And disabling these unnecessary applications during startup can definitely help your boot times. Lastly, we're going to focus on some gaming optimizations. These can take your games from a choppy mess to buttery smooth gameplay. We're going to go back to settings and select the gaming tab. When you click here, you'll see three options for game bar, captures, and game mode. First, we're going to look at the game bar. This is just an Xbox-esque overlay that will allow you to use your Microsoft account as you would on your Xbox. We are going to turn this setting off, unless you're someone who actually uses the Xbox game bar. In the captures tab, we'll want to turn off record what happened. This is basically shadow play, but worse. This should be turned off as Nvidia and AMD already have applications that do this, and it's kind of just not necessary to do it inside of Windows. And lastly is the game mode setting. Now this one is the most controversial, but you're actually going to want this turned on. This actually suspends background applications and gives your hardware an even better chance at performing at its peak. That's going to do it for this video, but don't click off just yet. Make sure to check out the links in the description to download some EasyUS products and give them a try for free. And also, if you enjoyed this video, please leave a like and subscribe and consider becoming a member, and I will see you guys in the next video.